Good morning, everybody. We're scheduled to start in about 10 minutes here. My internet has been acting bad, cutting in and out a lot, so if that happens, I'll have to stop the stream and switch to my backup connection, and everyone will just have to watch the game on YouTube. The YouTube recording shouldn't be affected by the internet problems. We've played against the OJD twice before, all the way back in 2020. We played in OTSL Season 1 and RTSL 2020B Brezhnev Division. Excuse me. And I won both of those. And we're scheduled to play this year in ITSL, RTSL, and OTSL. So this game today is going to be the ITSL, and then we're going to play the other two as asyncs, which have already started and are still pretty near the beginning. I think our opponent has improved since 2020. His rating's gotten higher, and in the league, he's 195th, very respectable. We've got like 950 players in the league now, so 195, very respectable. I'm up to 51st, so a win today should get me broken back into the top 50. And let's take a look at the ITSL standings here. I'm 12-6, and OJD is 12-7 over here in Santo Domingo. Is that right? Oh, I guess I just updated it. I was gonna say, I thought there was a different number. I have it on the standings here at 11-7. I guess I have time to fix it, don't I? I'll fix it real quick. They must have just updated that, because I just did that like 5 minutes ago. If I lose my last two games, I might not make the playoffs, but if I go 1-1, I think I've got a pretty good chance. Also, in all three of these games that we're playing, he's USA in all three of them. Beautiful. Yeah, the way it sits right now, it looks like some 12 and 8 players are in, some 12 and 8 players are not in. It kind of depends a lot on what happens in the rest of these games, too, because if a lot of people on the edge say, like, if he finishes 12, 7, and 1. He finishes 13 and 7. It might end up being that I think it's possible that a 13 and 7 player might not make it, but think 13 and 7 is probably going to be good enough. Even though my strength of schedule isn't really like amazing, which is the tiebreaker. If your win percentage is the same, then it goes to strength of schedule. And my only other ITSL game is against Craig, which has not been scheduled yet. Okay, it looks like we're about to start in 3 minutes. I'll be right back. I messed that up as soon as I did it. I knew I should have entered that OPEC first. It doesn't make any sense to space there. Oh yeah, that was stupid. Yeah, bad. Very bad. As soon as I did that, I knew I messed it up. Messed up that destall too. I should have gone one Venezuela, two Brazil, and one Argentina. I would have been a lot smarter. I was thinking about that and I messed it up. I can't decide whether to bear trap myself here or space it and hold grain. Tough. He should have surrounded Cuba right there. I made such a huge mistake with that D-stall. I could have dumped South America scoring earlier in the turn when I had presence if I had done it right. It was really, really bad. Should have gone one Venezuela, two Brazil, one Argentina. Or something like that. So I had presence. Doesn't make any sense to put one in Chile there. And then the mistake cascades through the whole turn. I just got lucky I didn't get surrounded in Cuba. That would have been even worse. But it's still gonna be pretty. I'm pretty far behind here. I guess even if I had done the D-stall that way, he still could have blocked it with the junta if he goes to put the influence in Brazil to break my presence and then coups. That's kind of tough. I mean, another way, yeah. I don't know. Maybe the way I did it was okay. I guess I'm all right with it. The more I think about it, this turn was still really ugly for me, though. And having to hold grain sales is super ugly. Well, I didn't do a very good job managing my time. Too used to playing those async games. I think I made a mistake there at the end. I should have known he had Central America in his hand. Whew, it's just enough. My time very well. I think if he saves the VOA until the end, he probably would have won. He could have gotten Asia domination broke. He could have gotten Asia domination and South America domination at the end with VOA. I played pretty sloppy too. I had a really interesting decision back here on turn five. I was thinking about using salt to pull Red Scare Purge back out. And then eventing Quagmire. I don't know if that's better than what I did or not. Also, I think I feel like I made a mistake. Maybe on turn 8 I should have headlined Pershing and pulled out of Canada and then cooed. This is another one. Even after thinking about it for a while, I'm still not sure what the best headline was here on turn 8. I mean, I spent a lot of time and almost ran out of time, but I had a lot of tough decisions in that game too. I mean, I spent a lot of time on decisions that weren't that tough also, which was not smart. But some of the decisions I had in that game were awfully complicated, like specifically, turn 5 and turn 8, I thought were particularly complicated. And then, not just the headline here, but also the AR1 play. I definitely started to get sloppy in the late war because I was low on time. But also, decal is another headline that I could potentially think about, or aims. I mean, all four of those are Lone Gunman, aims, decal, and Pershing, which is the card I held on turn 8. All four of those were headlines I was thinking about. I mean, I've got Africa scoring in my hand, so decal kind of makes sense. I feel like I kind of messed up when I gave him Asia, or I don't know. It's nice to have the China card, but I don't know. It was a wild game. Both of us were low on time, especially me. I almost ran out of time. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. I'll probably have my final ITSL game against Craig pretty soon, although it's not scheduled yet. And I don't have any other games on the schedule, but probably be back sometime in the next week or two. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you next time.